Hello, welcome to Fallout 76 Space Guide. Before I start, I just want to say that this is about 10 guides put into a single guide, and my base building, as you can see, is not that fanatical. I mean, this is your first base. If you want to expand it or build a better one, well, wait until you advance into the game. Now, my reasoning for this is simple, because your first base, and you actually the base you can use all the game, will be to get resources. And the main resources you need are food and water, because the more time you spend finding food and water, the more time you have for exploring and combat. Now, as you can see, you will need 5 water purifier, 5 water purifiers, and they need to be in the water, and also 5 generators. This is your basic setup, because purified water also gives you HP. This is exactly what you need. Now, for the food, you need corn. You need tattoo fruit, you need cranberries or blackberries or whatever they're called. And you also need some other plants, but we'll get into those later, and also the mud fruit. Now, the biggest problem people seem to have is finding all the necessary items for a base. Because you spend a lot of time searching, so as you can see, you have a bed, you have a cooking station, you have a water pump, and also are your station, crafting station. Here is your bed. And now, why do you need those specific plants? Well, that's very easy. Let's get into the recipe. Utility, vegetable starch. This is how you make adhesive. You probably know this from Fallout 4. So, mud fruit, corn, and tattoo. But I also said something else, didn't I? So you need a cranberry, yeah, that's the cranberries. To make the cranberry relish. So this will be a lot harder to find, I guess. But remember, you should search for them as soon as you can. And okay, I also made the blackberries because, well, they can make a good use. I'll cover this later in the game. But this is basically everything you need to know and how you'll start adventuring. Now, the other resources you will really need are of course junk, which is basically where you'll get all your gears, your screws and all the big things you can't have. Now, this is a bit of a tricky situation because I chose my location on a specific area because I wanted to be in this area and find out what's here. Now, you really need to explore everything around your area, so this is just one possible location, and I'll show you in a minute why I picked this, and I'll show you other locations. I just wanted to get here. So, I picked this location because it's very off the grid. I also have access to a lot of water, a lot of land, so I can plant my crops, and I also don't get a lot of enemies here. I didn't see any big spawns. On other locations you may get bigger spawns like ghouls or ticks or something else. I just got mongrels here. This is a daily quest. This is a daily quest. Okay, another daily quest. And as you can see, some people are starting to gather here because of the daily quest. And also some other quests. And as you can see, this is where I'll spend most of my month. This December I'll spend it here because I finished the upper part of the map mostly. So, another good base location, the one I previously had, is right here. Right here because you have easy access to this route, which has a lot of enemies and you can kill a lot of people. You also have the quest right here. You can also farm out this area and also explore that area. You also have some quests and you also have access to the Red Rocket Mega Shop. So this is a good location right here. And you also have access to the Sunny Top Station and, well, the other station, which has vendor bots, and you also have access to that area. Another good area to build your base would be somewhere around here, because you have all the basic utilities and you also have access to this large area. And then again, you can always explore or build your base near your favorite public workshop. So, oh, this guy claimed 2 workshops. Yeah, he's getting into it. He's really brave. Now, let me show you this public workshop, because this is the best one you can get with free junk. Now, let's use some purified water, because we're getting a bit thirsty. The problem with this game, I find it, is that this is not really meant for single player at all. So you really have to be a lot more creative when building your base and advancing as a single player. So part of this guide is actually me presenting you that... Okay, I won't defend it, it's not my base. Okay, I'll prepare my defenses right away. And as you can see, it teleports you to a nice location there. Okay, I'll just bother him a bit. So you have three junk piles right here, and I'll show you them because they're quite hard to see sometimes. This guy's probably wondering, what am I doing here? Okay. This is the first extractor, the first location of the junk. Now, the second location is very easy to see. We should get to it right away. It's right here. And the third location for the junk extractor is behind the house, right here. There. So, if you set up your base like mine, you probably have seen it. You'll have access to all those crops, the water, the junk from here. Well, you'll sometimes have to fight for it, but that's not a big problem, because usually you can get the workshop for 2 or 3 hours. And that's basically all you need. And you also have access to the daily quest. Okay, this is a good site as well. And now let me show you where to get those plants, because I want this to be a little of a more complete guide. And also you'll need some fertilizer, so you have to go to Flatwoods. Not sure where to get most of the crops that you need. And keep in mind, this base is always under construction, so you'll have to add a lot more things to it and also a lot more utility items, because yeah, you won't have a great time if you don't build up your base properly, because if you drink bad water, you'll get diseases, and those diseases can ruin your game. I mean, I was cut in a downward spiral for about 1 week, and I didn't make any video, I didn't want to play this game, because that was horrible. Basically, the bug that you know about destroyed my base. I didn't get anything out of it. I didn't have even one screw left. So you go here to Flatwoods, our friendly neighborhood town. And then you advance a bit here and you have the tattoo plants right here. And as I said, these are good for food, adhesive and some other resources. So collect the tattoo plants from here, but at the same time, you may want to go a bit further down here. Now let me see, where was that? Yes, here it is. That's a bit of a detour, right? Actually, you can go from there to there. And you can actually check this location out. It has a few enemies on it, but it has 2 red stag meat. And as you know, if you cook the meat... Excuse me. I'm busy. Yeah, if you cook the meat, you'll have extra carrying capacity, which is huge. In the first month of the game or so. As I said, this is more of a single player guide. So get that rest time, make, cook it and eat some, and then come here and get the wild mud fruit. But don't leave just yet, because you still have things to do here. You have to collect the fertilizer from here, because you need fertilizer to plant them. So collect them from that shack. Also get some more rat meat. Which is funny, and also another bag of fertilizer was there. And then you want to head out in this direction for more fertilizer for your base. Keep in mind, I'm showing you these routes because you'll get food and a lot of other resources as well. And you'll also have a clear goal in mind of where you want to be. And as I said, your base just practically has to be near water. Can be anywhere as long as you set up your base, but remember, moving your base will cost you a lot of time. So if you're playing with friends, maybe.
Biological material protected. Fertilize, grow.
Okay, you'll find another bag of fertilizer right here. This is also raw fertilizer. Okay, you just have to deal with these annoying robots. And also check those out, because you can get some good items as well. Oh, they're all wearing hats? Didn't notice that until now. Okay, so this is another one. And then you can actually go inside the building. The big building, that one, not this one that I'm about to show you. Go in there, because you'll also have a lot of fertilizer there. Oh, excuse me, I didn't want to scare you. Okay, so this basically has been my guide for the base building and the basic things you need for it. Also keep an eye out for that cranberry. And actually, let me expand this a little bit more. To get the gourd, I got it from here, the Ray Place Bunker, which has a few gourd planters, but you can get it anywhere on the map. And for the snaptail reeds, you can just go to Mama Dolce's and then follow this line right there. You'll get a lot of... Come on, I want to speak, leave me alone a bit. And you'll get a lot of snaptail reels for your sugar. So you'll have sugars and other things. And with those recipes, you can make a lot of good things. So before you venture out, you want to sleep, you want to take water, you want to cook some food, and you also want to lower your weight as much as possible, as you can see. And also use that grilled rat stack, so you increase your carrying capacity even further. Also use pocketed armor. This is not ideal, but once again, I'm in the farming phase, and basically you'll wear power armor all the time after a certain point, so why bother with it, right? Now, let's return to our base and I'll show you some other things I plan to do and expand it. Also, this is a good way of farming. Come on guys, leave me alone, I'm busy right now. So building your base is mostly about gathering resources and having access to the resources, so you don't waste a lot of time. And also have access to the Silva farm if I want to check out the power armor station, because you usually find power armor there and a lot of other supplies. And as I mentioned, I had my previous base locations were pretty good, but I feel this one is a bit safe. Because if I get moved to another server, I think my base will stay safe. But by making this video, I just compromised everything. So try to camouflage your base a bit, because as you can see, if you're running past here, you won't see anything. Yeah, you may see some plants and it will seem pretty weird to you, but you're basically safe. And also you may want to build only, as I said, 3 turrets and then build some camouflage around your base, some walls and some other things you may need. But the most important thing is, after you made your base, start gathering resources and start bringing things back. Because even the soups can be good. For example, this carrot soup, as you can see, it gives you food, water, and also regenerates your action points. And you also have the, as I said, this should be your main concern, the cranberry. The cranberry relish should be your main focus for the game, because it gives you bonus XP. And with that out of the way, you should have a perfectly fine time in the game right now. And keep in mind, this was a very compressed information guide for your basic base and how to get your some materials and where to get started. So if you have any other questions, let me just ask. Because by now you should have enough aluminium, you should have enough lead, you should have all your other basic resources settled in. So see you next time, bye bye.